I am actually going to throw my microphone out the window one of these days. It's not your fault, Snowball, I know, but it is you pissing me off. Well, it's not. It's just all the recording equipment that seems to think it's fun to not use the computer's default microphone, which I have set to the blue Snowball, and think it's more entertaining to use the crappy little thing that is literally a millimetre across, just embedded on my laptop. So anyway, hello everybody, Loz Midgley back once again with Banjo-Kazooie. This is a post-recording narration, whatever. Yeah, because WavePad and Audacity have both teamed up against me and decided they don't like me anymore. So, I will be using WavePad still. It's just I need to actually pay attention to what microphone it's using in the future. It's my fault more than anything, really. I'm just being an idiot with it, but maybe I'll actually do something right for once and pay attention to it. Anyway, we've still got some jiggies to collect here in Rusty Bucket Bay. We've got two left to do. One of them's right over there on the other side of the room, but we can't get that one just yet because I'm an idiot and forgot what order I should be doing things in. Not that there's a set order, but, you know, there's a good order. So we're going to be doing one that you need to be in here to activate. We need to be outside to actually collect. And it's really hard, and you're only certain to die on the way out. Which means you get the jiggy, but, you know. Anyway, it all starts by hitting this switch. And it slows down those propellers. Why, oh why, those propellers are actually moving when the ship is just in the bay? I don't know. It's not going anywhere. It's not doing anything. It's just sat there. You're wasting so much oil. Petrol? Boats don't run off petrol as far as I'm aware. You're wasting so much fuel. I mean, come on, save the planet. Or at least your small bay. This is the most amazing recovery I've ever made in this game. It was just fantastic that. I think I'm losing my voice. This is my second attempt at doing this. The first attempt, again, I used my microphone and the computer, which really isn't shit. Isn't good enough for this. It's a piece of shit, and I hate it. Although, it gets surprisingly good volume, considering it's all the way over there, and my snowball's right in front of my mouth. Anyway, here's switch number two, which will completely stop those propellers outside. It'll also trigger a timer, which isn't fun. When you've got to run like a shit, I don't even know anymore, like a bitch. You see, that's just how frustrated I am. I don't even know what I'm talking about anymore. Not that I do anyway, but you know what I mean. You can get those Mumbo tokens that are on either side whilst those propeller thingies are stopped, but I prefer to use my time wisely and go after those jiggies. That jiggy. There is also a honeycomb piece in a hole above the door. That we just came out of, which I got in a minute long recording that I did before I decided I couldn't take any more of this level for that day. It's easy to get into, just flip-flop jump up to the hole up the door, and there you go. There's also a Mumbo token on that first obstacle in the engine room. Anyway, right, so we have to run all the way to the end of the ship in 22 seconds. Run! Whee! Right, there's also some notes here, we'll collect those in a better time. And then dive, Banjo, dive! You know, even if I didn't like run out of time whilst behind the propellers here, I'd probably drown anyway, so yeah, anchoring yourself as well. Really hard here. Tricky. Go on, you can do it. You're the boss. See, the propellers have started. Grunty's gonna gloat. A simple task, you are sure. But Grunty's engines start once more, and there's no way out, so you just have to dice yourself. Which is an instant kill, which is always nice. Lovely game, this. Anyway, out we go. Then I spent ages trying to remember how to actually do the next bit. And then I remembered. And we go down here. I thought I'd collect these notes first. Collect. And some more. There's also a Mumbo token in that lifeboat there, so go grab it. Good bear. Right. Let's take a quick look at this flagpole, because I thought there was something on top of it. I may have collected it already, but I don't think I did. If there was something there, that is. Pretty sure there wasn't. Right, and then down this pipe. I know there's a proper name for those things, but I can't remember what it is. And now we're in here. Where there are notes, and one of those stupid grublin sailor thingies. Right, so let's get this switch. Okay, we'll get those notes first. Good bear. Right, now get the switch. I think I will do an LP of Banjo-Tooie once I've finished with this and the other two I'm doing. Well, maybe not both of them, but I don't know. I'm not my biggest quarrel is whether I'm going to do it as a blind or not, because I have never finished it, but I've finished most of it. so it's not technically a blind LP, but I've never finished it, so I don't know if it qualifies or not. Anyway, yeah, so that switch that we just hit slows down these fans, or it does periodically at least. You can see this look going slow there, and then they speed up again! And then I manage to get all 100 notes, which is always nice. And there's the last jiggy. Whoop-dee fucking do! We're out of here! Okay, we'll dance first, and then we'll get out of here. Right, underlay! Haha, skill. Right, so we've got to swim. And so begins another episode where I just continuously fail for about half an hour. Most of which was cut. Yeah, this recording was originally about 22 minutes long, but then I was like, no, sorry, and chopped out loads of shit. Pardon me. Right, so. Question is, where do we go now? Because I couldn't remember. But then it came to me like a dream. I have to go back out here. Through this pipe. Da-doop. Da-doop. Right, and here we go. Right, I still couldn't remember what to do, but then I noticed. Up there was a platform, and then I remembered that we had a witch switch jiggy to collect. So I grabbed it. Because it was there on that platform, all glittery and shiny. Yay! We all know about your new spell, Grunty, and I'm going to drop my microphone if I'm not careful. I don't want you to save it later. Use it now whilst I'm not there. And we got some feathers and some more feathers. Oh no, nothing there. Right, I want you all to pay attention to that grate, because I didn't. I completely forgot it was there, and we need to go through it. So, right, moving on. Okie doke. Now what? Where to go, Banjo? That's right, get up the platforms, because that's where we need to be. For now, at least. Well, could actually do with going through that grate, but that's not really important, I suppose. You can miss out that grate bit, but, it's great for a reason. Nah! Oh god, that was terrible. Right, so through here. Where could this mysterious tunnel lead to? I just realised something. That door we just went through didn't have the glowy red eyes and teeth like all the other doors that take you to new world rooms do. Mysterious. Or maybe it did and I just didn't look, because I'm an idiot and I'm blind. But look, a new cauldron! Oh my days, and it takes us all the way back there. Why could that be, I wonder? We'll find out eventually when we use that cauldron. I need to get some more Vanja, but I don't want to put down the microphone because it's resting on my boobs. As you do. Yeah. There's a note door there, we can go through it. We can actually beat the game with the number of notes and jiggies we have now, or at least I think we can. Because there's another compulsory jiggy to get, finish, complete, and it's one jiggy more than the click-clock wood jiggy is. Oh, there is a Mumbo token there. I knew it! Did I grab it? Am I just going insane? I probably am. Anyway, yeah. We can certainly do the note doors, apart from the last extra four. Can't do those. Yeah, I'm pretty sure we can. But we're not going to, because this is sort of like an unofficial 100% walkthrough. I did go and find those notes in Bubble Gloop Swamp and in, what was the other world? Gobi's Valley. I just never showed you on tape. The ones in Bubble Gloop Swamp were by those treehouse thingies. There were four down the side of those that I forgot about. I'm just pouring out Fanta, don't you worry. And then, the ones in Gobi's Valley. Oh look, I remember the grate, were in the temple pyramid, whatever, with the guy with the snake. They were in there, and I completely forgot. They were in one of the alcoves and they were hidden from view. Maybe if I'd gone into first person I would have found them. But no! I'm an idiot. And then I forgot where to go, and I paused to go in search of my issue of Endgame that lasted me 14 years. Back through here because I remembered where to go. I couldn't actually find Endgamer. It's lost once again. Little pitch up. When I finally give this room a long overdue clean. It's probably right in front of me, to be honest. I'm just being too blind and stupid to see it. Probably got mixed in with my issues of Nintendo Magazine. which I need to read. One of them's got some juicy information in Pokemon Black and White 2. I can't believe they're making Black and White 2. But look, Jido! And an achievement. Still missing a few of those, which is strange. Out of all people, you'd have thought I'd have got them all by now. Although I know so much to do with like 100% Jiggy collection and notes and shit like that. Anyway. Yeah. So, Cheeto gives us the final cheat. He's a lot more useful in the second game. His cheats are more interesting. But you gotta work harder to get them. Right. So we need to be down here, in the secret passageway with the secret cauldron. I wanna know who put the cauldrons there, or did they just kind of walk into place? I mean, they've got little feet there. Can't imagine it's very easy to walk when you're just two stubbly little feet under a cauldron, though. Anyway. Through the pipe we go. And look where we are! We're back here! Can you believe it? Mon ami! And there's a magical secret tunnel! Really hate tunnels. There is never a good tunnel. Never! Never a good tunnel! My issue with tunnels, I suppose, stems from the fact that I went potholing with this adventure group thingy. And maybe a month later, some kid from another school went down the same pothole. Pothole? It is called potholing, isn't it? Yeah, but the thing's not called a pothole. But yeah, this kid went down the same hole and he drowned. So that freaked me out a bit, and that's why I don't like tunnels. Not that that stops me from going down tunnels nowadays. It's just a reason to not like tunnels, I suppose. Brenty says some really gross things just here. Also, I'm Mr. Brenty. I know where she is and I'll go back and get her. She's in the entry room to Mad Monster Mansion. I'll go and grab her. Later on. Why that music's appropriate, I don't know. So, right game, but wrong place entirely. And the old hag's favourite colour, spelt American style, is gruesome green. I don't get why they spelt that colour without a U when this is an English-made game. If you look on the back of the Rusty Bucket Bay ship, it says, like, somewhere or other, England. Which is a reference to where Rare was based at the time. I don't know if they're still there or not. Can't imagine they're not. Don't think they'd have moved. Where did that Mumbo token go that I saw? I mean, or have I collected it already? Probably have, because I'm crazy like that. And I forget things that I did. Maybe it's a glitch. Maybe there never was a Mumbo token. Maybe Banjo's entered the Matrix. More of a Conker's Bad Fur Day thing. I'm really stuck on Conker's Bad Fur. Well, Conker Live and Reloaded. I'm trying to do this lava surfing bit. So fucking hard! I can just about beat it, but then I die by crashing into a dinosaur's foot or some shit like that. That's all the time I've got for today. Hope you all enjoyed. Thank you for watching.